Moving on to the security aspect of the elections, last week I interviewed CICC Executive Director Cesar Mancao. They arrested hackers who got access to Smartmatic from an ex-employee, and of course, I think eventually, that ex-Smartmatic employee is now missing. But the question on everyone's mind is, these hackers are essentially promising, no? Or that's what they were planning. They would promise politicians that we can alter or change or manipulate the results of the elections. They did get voters' information. That's what the information that was leaked, because Mancao said on Head Start, he saw voters' information that was all in the data. I mean, Commissioner, kaya ba talaga baguhin ang resulta? What do these hackers have?
No, ma'am. In fact, po, we are looking at the angle that itong mga na-arrest last week na tatlo, they are not even connected to the ones that we are looking for, the one that is a former employee of Smartmatic. Ang tawag po natin dyan, kahit na nagpa-practice ako, ma'am, hacker-hackeran eh. Sabi nila, hacker sila, sabi nila, kaya nila. Ang gagawin nila, they will go to the politician, 50 million, 70 million, campaign. Just give me an advance, we're going to buy equipment, we're going to buy somebody from the Commission of Election, from the Information Technology Department of the COMELEC, and then pupunta sa kabilang grupo, sa kabilang kabilang party, ay, the other party is offering us 100 million. We are offering you only 50. We believe that you'll be the one to win. So, give us advance. So, nakapag-advance sa parehas, pag kung sino yung manalo, babalikan. See? You won. It's because of us. So, sa natalo, well, the other party was able to pay a lot more than what we have paid. So, ganun lang talaga, talo tayo. So, why are these people having this data? Ma'am, in the COMELEC, you can easily, even in our website, you can look in the website, there are data there. At the same time, your list of voters, you can secure the list of voters from the COMELEC. You just file a formal petition or formal request to our executive director, who happens to be the data privacy officer of the COMELEC, and you can easily get that for a fee. Magbayad lang po kayo, kaya lang, PDF files lang po yun. So, ang gagawin po nila, magsisecure sila ng ganyan, magre-request sila, lalagay nila sa laptop nila, pakikita sa mga kandidato, see? We were able to get into inside the system of the Commission of Election. In fact, these are easily, you can easily request this data. So, mga ano po ito, mga manloloko ng mga sindikato. And so therefore, we can honestly say that our system is very secured. Ma'am, for the last, since 2010, I have not proven a single ballot box having changed the result as an election practitioner, whether for the Protestant or Protestant. There was not a single ballot box of which we opened, and when we counted the ballots manually, that's the easiest way to check whether the machines are counting properly or not. There was not a single ballot box that I opened.
But then, Commissioner, let's talk about presidential frontrunner Bongbong Marcos's junior concern, because it's interesting. I've heard in several campaigns, I've seen his campaign videos, and ginagawa na niyang biro sa mga supporters niya. O bibigyan ko kayong 3-in-1. Walang tulugan. Simply because referring to the 2016 elections wherein it was a surprise to many. I was anchoring at that time. He was leading. And then give it 6 or 7 hours after, just overnight, then it was then-candidate Lenny Robredo who took the lead. So clearly there were insinuations of possible cheating coming from maybe the administration and COMELEC. So ano nangyari? You were a lawyer then.
Yeah, I was the lawyer of Senator Grace po.
Yeah.
And I'm the lawyer of former Senator Bongbong Marcos in the election protest. But ma'am, now we can guarantee, and there's a guarantee from our steering committee, COMELEC Commissioner Marlon Casquejo, that indeed this glitch, the 7-hour glitch, will no longer happen. It will no longer happen. We were able to determine the reason. Try to imagine, ma'am.
Yeah. What was the reason? Just say it in layman's terms. What was the reason for that 7-hour glitch?
Yes, ma'am. Yung transparency server sa Tagalog po natin, nabulunan. Sa sobrang dami ng pumapasok na data. Kumbaga sa cellphone nyo, sabay-sabay ba namang nag-text yung lahat ng kaibigan nyo dahil birthday nyo, sabay-sabay. Hindi po lahat pumapasok kaagad. And therefore, minsan nagahang yung cellphone natin kahit yung pinakamagandang bago. Nagahang yung cellphone natin kasi po sa sobrang dami ng data na pumapasok, hindi niya kinaya. And but then, may pumapasok pong data. Kaya lang, from that cellphone, naka-mirror po yon sa mga media server, hindi nakakapag-push yung mismong server na ito, hindi nakakapag-push ng result sa mga media server, meaning sa mga laptop ng taga-ABS, taga-ANC, hindi sila nakakapag. Pero kita po ng mga media at that time na may pumapasok na data talaga sa server. Patuloy ang pagpasok, kaya lang po nagkaroon ng problema sa pag-push dito na po sa mga media servers, sa mga laptops po natin.
But then, what did the COMELEC do this time? Was there an upgrade of some sort? Because clearly, the one thing is some analysts predict that this might end up like a 2016 issue between Mr. Marcos and Vice President Lenny Robredo.
So, yes, this time we upgraded the system at the same time. Okay. From this server, the transparency server in UST, meron po kami nilagay na isang equipment na kung saan by bulk yung pagbagsak ngayon sa mga media server, yung sa laptop po ng mga media natin. Before po kasi kahit sa manggaling na presinto, try to imagine you have 106,000 precincts nationwide. So kung 106,000, noon po 80,000 ngayon, 106,000. And then po papasok lahat doon sa transparency server. Tapos ibabato sa mga media server yung raw data. That will be problematic. This time, it will be by bulk ang pagbato po niya. First 10,000, then next 20,000, next 30,000. So it will practically solve the problem.
Okay. So what do you think, Commissioner, with this upgrade of the servers, do you believe that by the evening of May 9th, we already know who'll be winning as president? Or do you believe it's the next day, May 10th?
During the last 2016, it was si Ma'am Grace, we already considered in favor of President Duterte. So maybe because we already have knowledge because of the sending of the data, of the results. Ma'am, in the evening of May 9, perhaps not yet po. Evening of May 9, we can only proclaim the mayor. Siguro po early part of May 10, we can proclaim the congressman, the governor, the vice governor, and the sangguniang panlalawigan. And by that time, we already have an inkling of who is the winning presidential and vice presidential candidate. Take note that the official canvass of the president and the vice president will happen only on May 23 when Congress will resume its session on June 3. But as far as the COMELEC is concerned, perhaps we can canvass the result of the senators and the parties up to May 15. We can already proclaim the senators or the party list. The latest will be May 16.
Okay. Now, are you planning, kumbaga, is there the COMELEC and bank, do you have a certain goal or target that you want this election, other than, of course, walang aberya, is the declarations are faster?
Hopefully, yes, ma'am. Simply because we already improved the system. The overseas voting will be here. The results will be here by May 9, May 10, more or less, after they have counted already. We already have set up the guidelines so that the ambassadors, the consuls will immediately bring the results. Now, we was able to improve the protocol in case the SD cards will malfunction or will be repaired. Instead of going to Santa Rosa, coming from Sulu or Basilan, Santa Rosa, Laguna, we already have established our provincial technical hubs to be manned by DICT and DOST personnel.
So and that's the first time.
This is the first time, Ma'am Karen. And again, for the first time since 2010, we have shown to the public, to the media servers, the servers that will be the data servers that will be used in Paranaque, in Libis, in BGC for the first time. And nagkaroon ng walkthrough. And beginning today, all of these servers will be live streamed. So everybody can see what is happening, who is going inside and out, going in the servers. So for the first time, ginawa natin to be transparent.
All right. Well, at least, I want to wish the COMELEC luck and good luck to the Philippines. Good luck to us all. Is there anything you want to add, sir? Because I think we just have a few days left and then it's the big day.
To our voters, what you are voting is the future of your country, the future of your children and grandchildren. This is the best opportunity for us to at least improve and develop our country. We have to elect the rightful leader. At the same time, we have to vote. Hindi po mangyayari yung makakapaghalal tayo na hindi po kayo boboto. This is a constitutional right, and this is the only opportunity in this part of the world that we are all equal. Whether you are rich or poor, old or young, we all have the same one single vote. So cast your vote on May 9.
All right. COMELEC Commissioner George Garcia, thank you for joining me today, and you take care today, sir.
Thank you very much, ma'am. Welcome, and more power po.